dinosaurs go bye-bye. We make stone tools and invent fire. Humans evolve and then migrate out of Africa. About 11,000 years ago, the last ice age ended. This is the beginning of the Holocene epoch, and it would usher in a radical change not only for the Earth's climate, but the way humans lived. Over the course of the next 6,000 years, cultures all over Earth would learn to grow crops and domesticate animals, inventing agriculture, the single source of human civilization as we know it. This time after the last ice age in Europe and Asia was called the Neolithic Revolution because it was indeed a revolution in the way humans lived. One of the oldest artifacts of human civilization brings us to 9500 BCE. In Mesopotamia, modern-day Turkey, there is a hill with a buried treasure. Gobekli Tepe is a Neolithic tell, or artificial mound that is 11,000 years old. It predates Stonehenge by 6,000 years, and its construction must have been a pain in the ass. Here's a 3D scan of the whole site. Those little blue people are average-sized humans for scale. Gobekli's builders arranged several massive stones in circular patterns, over and over again, through the millennia, the largest and oldest being 7 meters tall, weighing 50 tons, and aligned with the stars like Stonehenge. What's really special about this is that this is the oldest example of humans working together to build something, 5,000 years before we have found any records of a writing system, or metal tools for that matter. They have also found human skulls that have been carved and modified post-mortem. This is actually kind of common in this area, so much so that scholars have dubbed this as skull cults. The veneration of the dead has often been a sign of a mature culture. It's one of the things that separates us from the rest of the animals. About 1,000 kilometers south of Gobekli is the city of Jericho. It is the oldest continuously settled city from at least 9,000 BCE. Between 10,000 and 4,000, many cultures would learn to grow crops and domesticate animals. Let's put the origin of some of these crops and domestications in context. For the sake of brevity, we're only going to focus on a few areas that would become some of the first well-known civilizations. Mesopotamia, India, China, and South and North America. Coming back to Mesopotamia, the first civilizations to develop would be Sumer and Egypt some 6,000 years later. The dotted line is these cultures' prehistory, the part before writing, and the solid filled-in part is where these cultures are considered to have been fully formed. Mesopotamia has the oldest evidence of bread and beer making we've found. During that time, or shortly after, they started cultivating grains and domesticating sheep, cattle, and pigs. The pyramids wouldn't be built until about 2500 BCE. Roughly around the same time as Stonehenge. Moving to the Indian subcontinent, the Indus Valley civilization would exist here around the same time as Sumer, and then what would become India and other nearby cultures would grow from the Ganges River. Some of the things they cultivated would be the jujube, barley, and wheat, and they domesticated sheep and goats and cotton and elephants. Meanwhile, in China, the Yellow River and the Yangtze River Basin is the origin for East Asian civilization. Along these rivers, they cultivated millet and rice, and pigs and chickens were also domesticated too. Around here, some of the first cultures to use writing systems would be the Pailigong and the Jiahu cultures. On the other side of the world, in South America, there are exciting new discoveries being made along the Peruvian Andes. The Norte Chico civilization is the oldest civilization in the Americas, older than the Incas, Maya, or Aztecs. They cultivated the bottle gourd, beans, and potatoes, and domesticated llamas, alpacas, and guinea pigs. I hate to break it to you, but they didn't use the guinea pigs as pets. In Mesoamerica, squash was farmed around 8,000, and by 4,000, they had domesticated peppers, and wild teosinte was bred into corn. By 2100, sunflowers. And at some point before 500, they were the first to domesticate the tomato. Cultivating storable crops allowed early cultures to stockpile food on a large scale for the first time in humanity's existence. This was a profound change from the nomadic subsistence lifestyle that people had for the previous 400,000 years. They had a surplus of food for the first time in human history, and surviving got a lot easier. And as a result, human population began to grow exponentially. And eventually, specially tradespeople would develop metalworking, pottery, and crafts, and other accoutrements to civilization that we're familiar with. It's too difficult to summarize in one short video all of the developments that would lead to early civilizations. If you're interested in a more detailed and speculative look, check out my companion post that gets more into it. In the next episode, we'll go into detail on the first writing systems around the world. But for now, by 3500 BCE, Sumer, Egypt, and the Indus Valley civilization had full-blown writing systems. Well, maybe not the Indus, but the other two definitely. For China, we don't really have evidence from older than 1250 BCE found on the oracle bones, although I wouldn't be surprised if it was older. China's kind of a black box, as you might imagine. Norte Chico never really developed a symbolic written language that we can recognize, but these quipu that were discovered may have actually been a proto-writing system. And the Mayan script wouldn't develop until around 300 BCE. So much of the oldest known evidence is in the Middle East because that's where we were looking, where we put in a lot of work. I'm sure there's a mountain more hiding under our feet all over the world, and I cannot wait to see what the future holds. Thanks for watching. Subscribe. If you liked it, hit the like button. And don't forget to check out the companion piece on the main site.